Strangers in
the... I mean, we've had Soap Aid, Live Aid, Band Aid, and now my new campaign, and a very worthy one, Deaf Aid.
Forget it, Wesley.
Mona Lisa, Mona Lisa, men have me.
Mr. Colwyn Stanley.
My name's, Worthington.
And don't forget, he's singing for the deaf.
Yeah, wish I was one of them.
Get tuned to Brothers McGregor, Wednesday, 10:35 on ITV.
Women drivers and Japanese feminists, as covered by television and Clive James, next on Granada.
The summer Peugeot 309s. Best to beat the rush.
Each and every day, TSB grants over £1 million in personal loans to its customers, swelling their bank accounts by just the right amount to help them pay for a new car, a new kitchen, or whatever they've set their hearts on. Ask about a personal loan at your nearest branch of TSB, the bank that likes to say yes.
Eye of newt and toe of frog.
Wind of bat and tongue of dog.
And three spoons of sweetener.
That'll taste disgusting.
Some sweeteners won't cook at high temperatures, but Sweetex uses NatriBlend, so all your cooking tastes wonderful.
Still needs a little something.
Sweetex. Now you can have your cake and eat it.
Everybody's playing Birthday Lotto.
Only in the Super Daily Mirror.
Birthday Lotto is the easiest game in the world.
Just look in the mirror.
If we've printed your birth date and initials, you could win up to £75,000.
You can even win for anyone in your family.
There's a new birth date every day.
Exclusively in your Super Daily Mirror. Play it tomorrow.
Arnold here. The long-range weather forecast of sunny spells has thrown us into an absolute fever here at Gamers. So much so that we've had to go into overtime making our famous Old English cider. Gamers Old English cider. Every drop's been dripped and dripped and dripped.
People are a special kind of energy, he said, like electricity. So they can never really die.
Coincidence? Sure.
Two mass psychotic outbreaks in 5 years. Coincidence?
I give you the human brain.
Artificial intelligence is about making models, Mr. Raines. Models of the mind. Start confusing the model with the thing itself, and I'd say you really are getting into Frankenstein territory.
Tonight's drama at 9:30 is the ITV play Chekhov in Yalta, in the title role Tom Courtney. That follows the news. Now the television from other countries, as seen by the one and only Clive James.
Guess what? I'm wearing no knickers. And now no knickers for me. I'm fed up with knickers that wrinkle and pinch and dig into me. So now I'm wearing no knickers. I'm as comfortable as can be. And all you can see through my clothes is, well, all you can see is me. Yes, now I'm wearing no knickers. I'll say it till I'm hoarse. I'm honestly wearing no knickers. Through Holbrook, of course.
That Australian commercial was showered with awards and feminist outrage. Younger female viewers who have vaguely heard that men used to give up their seats in trains to women who were merely pregnant instead of dying might sometimes wonder whether the struggle for equal rights has been worthwhile if all it gets you is an equal right to be made fun of. But a look back at the way things were more than 30 years ago might allay their doubts. Things really have improved.
Extra, extra, read all about it. Extra, extra.
What? Here you are, lady. Thank you.
Extra, extra.
Say, this is new.
Big news. Look. Amazing new lipstick now protects as it beautifies. Isn't that great? Keeps lips from getting dry and irritated, even on coldest days. Gee, that's just what I needed.
Girls, Hazel Bishop's creamier new formula lipstick is just what you need, too, because Hazel Bishop now gives you the biggest extra in lipstick history. Wonderful new ingredients that actually soothe and soften your lips, keep them feeling smooth and comfortable.
Kissable, too. See? No lipstick news. Yes, Hazel Bishop's lovely new colors stay on you, not on him.
When you couldn't mention sex, sticky lips meant marriage. The idea being that a woman should have a mouth so gooey that any man who kissed it couldn't fight his way free. In the 60s and 70s, there was a false dawn of feminist freedom when the girls in the commercials were given a chance to do manly things.
Who says beer is a man's beverage? Women like box? Boxes of candy. Big shiny rocks. Hair tubes are dandy. And beer. They like bargain sales. Combing the attic. Strong, handsome bales. Anything automatic. And beer. Cold beer. Bright beer. Gold beer. Light beer. Cheering beer. Mellow beer. Endearing beer. Swallow beer. Sublime. Divine. All mine. Beer. With a book, with a friend, with a smile, with a frown, with everything. We like beer. Thanks a lot.
You're very welcome. Recently, it's been happening. Women are discovering the good taste of beer and ale, finding out for themselves just how refreshing a glass of cold beer can be on any occasion. And because beer is such a bright note on an evening like this, gentlemen, shall we join the ladies?
Back in the old days, certain rights were for men only, such as thinking, such as smoking. So, after dinner, the ladies were politely dismissed to the sitting room. The men talked politics and puffed their fat cigars. It's different now.
You've come a long way to get where you got to today.
This is the Slim cigarette made just for women. New Virginia Slims. Slimmer than the fat cigarettes men smoke, with rich Virginia flavor you'll like. New Virginia Slims in the striped purse pack.
And her ex-husband's severed head was in the hat box. The advertisers thought they were being generous, but they were just being patronizing. All they were offering was the chance for women to ape male status by smoking and drinking, while leaving the same old thick pink stain on the rim of the beer glass and the cigarette stub. Today, those commercials are actually more embarrassing to watch than the ones they were trying to break away from. In the 1950s, there was no doubt that a woman's place was in the kitchen, and television devoted whole programs to ensuring things stayed that way.
Now, I'd like to remind you about the special offer of a continental wooden mixing spoon by the Goodwin Extra Glass. Remember? You may remember it, anyway, that I told you you could obtain one of these most useful spoons by sending in a strip of stamp and either 3 seals from 1-pound bags or 1 seal from 3-pound bags of Goodwin's Extra Self-Raising Glass. And now here's Monica Mawson again with another lovely recipe.
Thank you, Daphne. Splendid to know that so many of you wanted to try our scraper spoon and were thrilled with the toasted icing for the cake. Now, this time, we have to have pancakes in mind. So I thought you might like to try something a little different from our usual thin pancake with lemon. The Danes make a thicker variety, and they serve it with an orange and almond sauce. For the sauce, this is the rather coarsely grated orange, and those are the slices of almonds, just to show the size of the pieces. The pancake itself, which is delicious, made with Goodwin's Extra Self-Raising Flour, is thicker than ours, you see. And it's flat, not rolled. And as it's thicker, it's quite sufficient for each person. Just for the complete recipe, just write to Goodwin's Hall Street, Dudley. Now, pour over the sauce, and a happy pancake day to you all.
A woman could leave the kitchen only to attend elocution lessons, to have her hair permed and compare wooden spoons with the woman next door. Going over the wall to get out of that kind of prison was a big decision, like the repudiation of monastic vows. American women agonized over their duty right there on the little screen.
This woman is facing the most difficult decision of her life. She is here to see what most other people would do in her place. Those of you willing to help this neighbor come to a sound conclusion by listening to her story and voicing your frank and objective opinions, stand up and be counted. Where everyday people from all walks of life relate and discuss personal issues, will present its guests and their dramatic stories, stand up and be counted.
Would you please tell us in your own words of your dilemma?
Yes, Mr. Russell. I've been a stenographer for the past 20 years. I have also, as an only daughter, had the responsibility and care of my parents who weren't well. Well, a few years ago, my mother passed away, and just recently, my father passed away. And since I had lived a very limited life going to work and coming home, right now, I feel I should live a little before life passes me by completely, and I wouldn't have been able to afford it up until now.
Now then, what is your opinion? You've heard Ms. Gurin's story. I know that you'd like to state your opinions to help this American neighbor. Those of you willing to voice your views, come forward now. Come up, ladies and gentlemen, up to this rail, and tell this young woman what you would do in her situation. Let me ask this lady right over here, this girl right here.
I think that she should go on with whatever she wants to do with the money and have a good time. She's had so much care and responsibility of be of therapeutic value to do this thing.
Mm-hmm. What do you think?
I feel that she invested all her life for her parents, and she's entitled to have her own happy life, and she should.
Thank you.
I think she's stayed for 20 years. She has to think of her security.
I think she's worked hard all these years, and she should take a trip to, and perhaps she may meet a man. She's unmarried. Yes, but don't forget, life is a gamble. You can lose money in business also. But money can be lost in business. Money isn't that important.
Mm-hmm.
And
money
if she takes
important.
This trip...
Money, what is your life about money?
It's not the most important thing in the world.
Thank you, girls. Just a moment, please. Let me ask this man here, if you don't mind. This man here.
A short vacation trip will not solve this person's life in the future. She actually must save a little and look ahead for the future. It's her own security.
Security.
In the future is more important.
She should take the trip. She's a young woman yet, and she has 20 years yet to work, and the man should have her social security. She'll be a young woman then at the time.
Well, no.
Too many young girls today and too many women today feel that if they take trips, they're going to find romance. All they're going to find is somebody that's looking for a meal ticket.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
In those days, a woman could have security or she could have romance, but not both. Nobody doubted that giving yourself up to marriage meant giving up on yourself. Many women would say the same situation still exists, but in Germany today, the Hausfrau is at least allowed to fantasize.
Ist was, Liebling?
Nein. Wieso?
Dachte nur.
Every second woman in Germany has secret sexual fantasies. Petra tells you what they are.
I was going to say she can whip up a souffle in two shakes of her husband's tail. But I decided not to. The American bride is allowed to be even dreamier in her approach to kitchen duty. If the groom can't stomach what she dishes out, too bad.
Just think of first home-cooked meal, dear.
Honey, you know, I'd never seen a dumpling that big.
I wanted to impress you.
It was all perfect, darling. Just perfect.
Well, let's see. What would you like for tomorrow, dear? Is it beginning to rain, dear?
No.
Marshmallows, meatballs. Poached oysters.
What law doesn't conquer, Alka-Seltzer will.
In Latin countries, getting married used to be everything a woman could desire. The same idea might still be there deep down, but the surface has altered to the point where advertisers can at least toy with the notion that the bride might want something else.
Junior woman,
cacao per corsa e sale. Il colpo di pugno.
Two thrilly images done for in one commercial. The obedient bride and the incompetent woman driver. Until very recently, women provided most of the light relief in car commercials.
All right, now let's see if we can find first. No, that's not it. Believe me, it's in there somewhere.
No matter how rough you treat a rebel, it's awfully hard to hurt it. A survey of professional driving schools shows that they use more of our cars than any other kind.
How am I doing?
A lot better than yesterday. Turn left.
I can't do it while you're watching me.
Okay, turn left. How does it feel the first time out in traffic, Mr. Moss? Mr. Moss? Mr. Moss?
The rebel has held its own against some of the worst drivers in the world.
Should I turn the windshield wiper on?
At this point, it looks like the rebels are going to outlast the teachers.
Dans la Volvo, on trouvait partout de confort, 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 et de sécurité, et de sécurité, et de sécurité.
Dans la Volvo.
Hey, Volvo.
Smart advertisers, even in the days of black and white, realized that a knowledgeable woman driver would be an even better joke, but only because women drivers were supposed to be clueless.
Let's stop. Engine's rough.
Sounds like pounds. When did you change your oil filter?
Change my what?
Oil filter.
Oil filter?
I'll show you.
I just got an oil change.
Hey, wait a minute. You changed your oil, but you didn't get a new Purolator oil filter. Now you've got an expensive engine job. It's ridiculous. Pour nice clean oil through a worn-out filter. Look at that glop.
Now what?
Listen to your service station, ma'am, when he tells you to get a new Purolator oil filter. It has a micronic element up to 11 feet long. It keeps out nearly twice the dirt other filters do. Stops particles small as 39 millionths of an inch. Purolator oil filter stop engine damage before it starts. Now, what did you have in mind?
She was meant to be a fantasy, and everybody knew it, women included. Women could ride in cars and even drive them in a straight line on a clear day. But understanding cars was a man's business. Macho and machine were practically the same word, and the script for a car commercial had hair on its chest.
Gonna take me a press, gonna take me some steel, gonna take my two hands and build an automobile. Put in a rivet and a welder and a look alive. Wait till you see this baby drive. Turn her out, Henry!
Heads up, she's coming down. 2 months ago, 3 tons of unmined ore. Today, a designer's idea come to life. Swift and mighty in action.
I took me a press. I took me some steel. I took my two hands and built an automobile. I built a Dodge.
I took me a Valium after that. People wanted their cars to fulfill their fantasies. The manufacturers wanted people to buy a new fantasy every year. The result was some of the most extravagant advertising campaigns ever mounted, as we'll see after the break. Meanwhile, here's how not to close your car door before leaving for the office.
Here's another one from Shaw.
Mm-hmm.
For people who lead an active kind of life, Shaw Active Deodorant. It won't let you down.
Nah, I got a dog.
Hi, Gar. You never told me you were into martial arts. Oh, no. I'm only coming here when the pub's packed.
Hi.
But I thought we'd come out tonight for a pint of skull.
Yeah, that's right.
Well, you can't get Skull in here.
Yes, you can. You just got to know where the bar is. Skull. Horribly good lager.
If you don't get the best pensions advice... Watch out. The Halifax Personal Pension Service. It could well be your best plan.
A new little princess and the nation rejoices. But there are some people who will not share our joy. 35 years ago, the Queen had one security man at Trooping the Colour. Now she has 3,500. This week and today, discover how safe the royal family really is in The Bullet Catchers. Exclusive revelations about the royal bodyguards. Plus, only in today, Kylie opens her heart about her three favourite men in Neighbours and her real-life heartbreak on the set. Get the newspaper of the year. Today.
Choir girl singing from the sky proved that nobody could promote a car like Chevrolet. Everybody could build a car like Chevrolet because all the American cars were pretty much the same under the chrome trim. So the big sell was crucial, and Chevy knew how.
What performance!
What convenience!
What brakes?
What comfort. How luxurious.
What a car.
What kind is it?
A 1961 Chevrolet. What else?
Or the closest thing to a magic ride. See your Chevrolet dealer.
The car looks look so much better when it was invisible. But what a commercial. How did they do it? The trick photography is still a puzzle, even by today's Steven Spielberg standards. Another Chevy Magic Picture commercial is easier to figure out, but imagine the expense.
Venice. Fabulous blend of reality and fantasy. Where anything goes on water, but nothing goes like Chevrolet. This is a most unusual Chevrolet. An Impala Super Sport convertible with extra cost options to go with the opulence of Venice. What a combination, the old beauty of Venice and the new beauty of Chevrolet. Even in Venice, where they've seen everything, Chevrolet's jet smooth look of luxury attracts attention.
Guarda la bella macchina!
Incantevole!
Incredibile!
What's that you say? A Chevrolet couldn't really drive on a Venetian canal? Of course it couldn't. So go for a jet-smooth ride in your neck of the woods. You'll be on solid ground with the truly beautiful value of Chevrolet. See your Chevrolet dealer soon.
You guessed how they did it, didn't you? Yes. Esther Williams was holding the car up from underneath. Other manufacturers had a less sure touch. In America, Ford came unstuck hugely with the Edsel. The Edsel was for some reason named after Henry Ford's son, as if Henry Ford hadn't already puzzled the world enough by naming his son Edsel. The car's appearance, meant to remind you subconsciously of your mother, on the conscious level was to frighten the horses. This fact was only emphasized by the TV launching ceremony, in which many stars of the first magnitude sang hymns to the Edsel's allegedly unearthly beauty.
Live from Television City in Hollywood, Frank Sinatra, Rosemary Clooney, Louis Armstrong, and Bing Crosby.
And now we'd like to show you how the Ford Motor Company has opened the gateway to a whole new world, a new vista of motoring pleasure with the 58 Edsel.
Won't you come in?
This is the Edsel, unlike any other car you've ever seen. You can see how it looks. You have to feel the power of the newest V8 engines in the world, the big new Edsel 400 and the larger Edsel 475. It is unlikely you have ever driven a car with so much usable power as the Edsel. And with Edsel's exclusive Teletouch Drive, you drive more safely, more easily than you ever have before, because both hands can stay at the wheel while the Edsel shifts electrically. This is the Edsel. As its graceful flight deck and classic vertical grille suggest, it is elegant in every detail. And it acts the way it looks, but it doesn't cost that much. See, drive, and be sure to price the new member of the Ford family of fine cars, the Edsel, at your Edsel dealer.
The public immediately sussed that the Edsel was a turkey with a wheel at each corner. They didn't buy it. Ford's weathered the storm, but the Edsel campaign was a turning point in the history of advertising. It proved that all the hype in the world couldn't sell the public what it didn't want. If your product was good, however, you could sell it by underselling it.
And now the star of the 1949 Auto Show. The car of the future. The car the public wants. The all-new DeSoto.
The long skirts will be the next look on the fashion scene. The Studebaker will be the next look on the automotive scene.
So there's no doubt about it. Next year, every car in America will have holes in its side.
So plan to see if you're buying your next car for keeps is your nearby Packard dealer.
Longer,
lower,
wider.
The 49 Hudson is the car for you.
So Volkswagen will constantly be changing, improving, and refining this car. Not necessarily to keep in style with the times, but to make a better car, which means to all of you, better mileage.
Of all the promises made at the 1949 Auto Show, we at Volkswagen kept ours.
Volkswagen didn't assume that the public had been fooled by all the hoo-ha for big cars. They assumed that the public hadn't been fooled and would favor anyone who sent up the razzmatazz.
The Volkswagen Karmann Ghia is the most economical sports car you can buy. It's just not the most powerful.
I'm actually stably being of sound mind and body to hereby bequeath the following. To my wife, Rose, who spent money like there was no tomorrow, I leave $100 and a calendar. To my sons, Rodney and Victor, who spent every dime I ever gave them on fancy cars and fast women, I leave $50 in dimes. To my business partner, Jules, whose only motto was spend, 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 I leave nothing, nothing, nothing. And to my other friends and relatives who also never learned the value of a dollar, I leave a dollar. Finally, to my nephew Harold, who oft-times said, a penny saved is a penny earned, and who also oft-times said, gee, Uncle Max, it sure pays to own a Volkswagen. I leave my entire fortune of $100 billion.
It was a winning ploy, not admittedly for big sales in the short term, but for steady sales over the long haul. Volkswagen weren't the only ones, however, to spot the vulnerable point about big American cars. The finance houses were always keen to remind car buyers that a car designed to be replaced annually was a car designed to wear out.
Yes, sir.
Bring up 13.
Yo!
Miss.
Oh, yeah. Hi, how are you? It's fine, thank you.
I want to see who has the nerve to get into that.
Anybody get hurt in that wreck?
13? No, mine's a Coco convertible. You know, I could probably get that guy the money for a new car in 24 hours. Legally? Sure, I work for Manufacturers Hanover. We make more auto loans than any bank in New York.
Yeah, but you wouldn't give that guy a loan, would you?
We don't make any money turning people down.
Can you get me, him a special deal?
If that guy qualifies for his loan and has a checking and savings account with Manufacturers Hanover, we'll reduce the annual percentage rate on his loan.
You getting this?
Nice talking to you. I'll see you.
I'll see you tomorrow at the bank. Coco convertible. Yellow taxi.
Manufacturers Hanover. It's banking the way you want it to be.
But his new car would have soon started falling apart, too. Dynamic obsolescence meant depreciation, even if the car stayed in the garage. If it came out of the garage, it might get damaged, which is where the insurance companies came in.
Helt försäkring ska jag ha, ja. Bilnumret, jag ska kolla. Ja, har ni köpt den som sagt? Det är CPM 572.
572. Ja, tack. Det var
That Scandinavian insurance company has discovered that a charming, clever commercial is not just the nicest, but also the most penetrating way of reminding people of what they don't want to be reminded of, that lightning might strike them. Paying a premium hurts, but it hurts less when you see other people being hurt more.
Det var alltså en hel försäkring ni ville ha?
Ja, just det.
Ja. Och bilnumret, det var LES-519. Ett litet ögonblick bara.
Tack.
Hallå?
Ja?
Då var det klart då.
If we share the laughter, it's somehow easier to admit that the dice roll against us too, and not just against the other guy. So all the world's insurance companies have gone comic.
You've both worked hard to establish a wonderful way of life. But what if one of you were no longer in the picture? Luckily, you have total way of life coverage from Independent Life. It protects your total lifestyle so that you can go on living in the manner to which you've grown accustomed.
This is the foot that kicked the skate, that swung the door, that hit the vase, that hit the plant, that pushed the light, that struck the picture, that toppled the table, that knocked the radio, that scared the dog, that bumped the chair, that shoved the piano, that collapsed the wall, that belonged to the lucky guy who was insured by Continental Insurance. Continental doesn't just insure the ordinary things that can happen. We can even insure the things that just can't happen. But
years ago, the only old people in commercials were lovable grannies. Today, it's all different, even in America, where old age used to be a crime, but has now become a commercial asset. If older means wiser, the shaky voice has the ring of authority.
Yeah, it's time to take the rabbit to the pet store.
I think I'll rent a trailer.
A lot of folks call Jar Train when their business expands faster than expected.
Ed, I think we'll have to get a truck.
You see, most Jartran trucks have automatic transmission, and they all have a low price.
Ed, I think we'll need a bigger truck.
So when you need a truck for your business or your family, just call your Jartran dealer, and he'll hop right to it.
Jacks. They're not for everyone.
Dunkin' Donuts introduces what we think are the perfect muffins. Grandma's, what do you think?
They're all right. They taste exactly like my own secret recipe. See you in court, Sonny.
Well, I won't be making these anymore. Well, they're even better than yours, Wanda.
The perfect muffins baked fresh every day at Dunkin' Donuts. They may put your grandmother out of business.
All right, they're wonderful.
When your car knocks driving up a hill, does it seem like everybody passes you?
Everybody's passing
you. I'm well aware of that fact, Eunice.
Comment, Walter.
And I took note of the comment, Eunice.
Maybe you need the higher octane in Texaco Super Unleaded. In tests against regular unleaded, it boosted acceleration for already powerful turbo cars almost 12%.
Isn't that where your lads? We went to high school together.
By golly, you're right. I thought Werner was dead.
Texaco Super Unleaded. Superstar power for more car power.
Out with the old and in with the new.
I'd like some Camay, Mr. Rogers.
Oh, Miss Becker. Old Camay or new Camay?
What's the difference?
Oh, twice as much lather in the new Camay. Super lathering Camay. So much more lather, so much more cream. Twice as much lather.
I feel it.
Twice as much cream.
I feel it.
Imagine all that lather putting all that cream on your skin, Miss Becker.
I feel it.
Bert? Lucille? New super lathering Camay. Twice the lather, twice the cream. To believe it, you've got to feel it.
After the break, we'll see how women in the age of equality face tougher hazards than soft soap. Meanwhile, if you're still looking forward to growing old, don't forget the importance of insurance. Think long, think secure, and think of the totally unexpected.
Gunpowder won't shift that lipstick, Mr. H.
Well, actually, Mrs. B, I use this.
Aerial liquid?
Just rub a smidgen onto...
Look, dear, I'm the lady who does. You're the person who doesn't.
But, Mrs. B, it's so advanced, it even comes with its own washing machine, the aerialette.
I'll never get a full load in there.
Just fill it up, chuck it in, and whack it on cool.
I'll do it again when he's finished.
It starts doing the biz, slap bang in the heart of the wash. There, Mrs. B. The whole wash cleaner than a clergyman's conscience.
Mm. Aerial liquid. Clean to the heart of the wash.
Incredible. It's even managed to clean up your image, Mr. H.
The East End. I grew up begging ha'pennies in these streets.
In a Sun serialization, Derek Jameson tells his incredible rags-to-riches life story.
But I fought my way out of the gutter to the top in Fleet Street.
The women he loved and lost, his disastrous court case.
I was wiped out in there, 40 years of my life down the drain.
And how he fought back to find fame, fortune and true love. The book all Britain wants to read.
I've got one hell of a story, and it's only in the Sun.
When you walk through the storm, hold your head up high, and don't be afraid of the dark. Walk on, walk on, with hope in your heart, and you
obviously, you can't walk and chew gum at the same time. Can't you put that together? Have you ever flown in an airplane or buckled your seatbelt up in a car? Have you? Mm-hmm. Huh? Don't you have any pride in yourself? No, you don't. You have no pride in yourself, because if you did, you wouldn't look like this. It's disgusting. I can't believe that you walk in here like that and look like this. But I'll try to help you. The only reason you come in here is just to see me anyway, Mr. Wonderful. That's the only reason you come in here. Let's try to work on your pecs. You know what a pec is? Such a pec. Okay? We're going to try to take some of this, and put it there, okay? Big pecs. That's what we want. Big pecs. Your husband will love big pecs. Okay, grab this right here. Give me about 20 reps with them. Okay? Push them up and think about what you're doing. Make them pecs work. Make them work. Yeah, that's right. Make them work. You know, this woman here is totally so far gone that I don't know if there's anything to be done for her or not, if you want to know the truth.
You have to do a lot of press-ups to get a brain like his. All Weight Watchers, including myself, dream of moving it from down there to up here, where it started its long slide. You can do it if you eat the right things. Just eating a bit less of the wrong things isn't enough. But people will diet, And women in particular will do a lot to make that hopeless diet work.
I'm going to turn the machine on, and at first, you're not going to feel anything at all. As a matter of fact, the machine is on right now. Whenever you hear that click, you know it's on.
Go ahead, pick it up. Take a bite. That's it. Go on. What's the matter?
I got a shock.
Pick it up. Come on, you like hamburgers. You told me that.
Yeah, I love hamburgers.
Pick it up and eat it.
That's a good-looking hamburger there.
Sure is.
Take a big bite. Take a nice big bite. I'm going to let you take a bite this time.
Really?
Sure. It's going to be a shock. I'm going to let you. How'd that
taste?
I don't
want the hamburger.
See anything else you'd like there?
Yeah, how about the french fries?
Go ahead. Why don't you pick up a handful?
That's it.
Okay.
What's the matter?
I got a shock.
Come on, take some more. Go ahead. You love them. Eat them.
Come on,
Gene. We know you like french fries.
No, I don't want any french fries.
Come on, Gene. I thought you really loved them.
Come on, take a bite. Go ahead. Come on.
You don't want to do it,
Gene. You don't want to do this.
Oh, I can't eat them.
How about something to drink? You've been working pretty hard here. How about taking something to drink? Go on. You like this. How do you feel about chocolate milkshakes?
I love chocolate milkshakes.
Okay. Pick it up and take a drink.
The hairstyles on those men should have been enough to put her up grease all by themselves. How you feel about being fat depends on how fat your friends are. In cold climates like Finland's, people can carry more kilos with less criticism.
Little Minnie Miss. Busy Mrs. Medium. And cheerful Maxi Mama. The Ama range offers you tights for every taste. And only Ama for all sizes.
Maxi mamas get even maxier as you move towards Moscow, or at any rate, the world thinks they do. So a commercial made in the West can take it for granted that women weigh more in the East.
Having no choices, no fun. So everyone who wants choices is at Wendy's. Wendy's has a new light menu featuring light calorie salads, hot stuffed baked potatoes with many delicious toppings, 6 kinds of sandwiches with regular or multigrain buns, hot chili, and more. Having a choice is better than not.
Is next. Swimwear.
Wendy's, there's no better choice.
It's a nice commercial, but the only way to stay thin and still eat hamburgers is to throw away the bun and then throw away the burger. Yet being big around the bust isn't the worst fate. Some women in America, 40 years after the first falsie, still think that being small around the bust is serious enough to warrant deception.
Hormone gum doubles your measure, doubles your gun. Now available for boys.
The The message is, be content with what you've got. Nobody listens, least of all in Japan, where women want the Western shape and will pad like mad to get it. As we revealed in an earlier show, they'll stuff their knickers to get a rounder hip line, but they'll go bananas to get a bigger boob line. Whole TV programs are given over to those few Japanese women who are born big enough not to need assistance.
じゃあ、ちょっと。これでちょっと濡らしていただけ。やった。このアイデアの強さ。だから、この辺は痛い。いいのかな、こういうの。いきますよ。あ、あ、なんだ。ああ。ああ、びっくりした。おお、面白い。薄いな、これ。面白いな。面白い。
She was actually built by the Sony Corporation. And there's room for a compact disc player between the speakers. The answer to your unspoken question is, yes, he was spraying water on her in order to secure a firmer outline. And no, he wasn't trying to spot clean her T-shirt. A recent survey in Japan showed that many people felt matters of sex were dealt with too explicitly on TV. Maybe they don't regard what you're about to see as either sexy or explicit. But non-Japanese viewers eating a TV dinner should close their eyes now. Feminists might complain that in a world of truly equal opportunity, the women would be free to put the heels down their own knickers without help from male chauvinistic hands. But the Japanese have already thought of this, and in the game you are about to see, the ladies are allowed to help themselves. Four flag-draped coffins confront the lady contestants, who shiver in the snow as the wound-up front man explains that they are about to go on a marine wildlife expedition, the winner of which will be the contestant with the greatest number of repellent life forms stashed in her plastic pants. Contestant number one is the first to find out that to pick up the trophies, she has to go down into the icy water, where what look like short lengths of wholemeal spaghetti turn out to be water-dwelling worms. Having dutifully stowed a handful of worms into her plastic knickers, she is hoisted into coffin number two, where a dozen giant toads are waiting to get into the act. The giant toad, having joined the water-dwelling worms aboard the plastic pants, coffin number three is uncovered. Worms and toads she can take, but the even more suggestive newts are apparently a bit much. The next contestant is bravely groping around in coffin number two after a toad to put into her pants.
Oh,
But will she also be flipped out by the newts? Banzai, and it's on to the last coffin, where the eels, who must be wondering how they got into this, lie in wait. Back in coffin number two, the final contestant hopes to get her hands on a prize 2-pound toad that has so far avoided capture. But the sensible toad has other ideas and tries to take cover in her hair. The 2-pound toad having been winched aboard to hold down the worms, the final contestant now braves the newts. She shouted because that big boy toad bit her fingers in its eagerness to engulf the intrusive newt. So you can understand the apprehensive air of the eels. Have they still got time to ring their agents and get out of this? I think we've proved that in Japan, full equality for women is now an established fact. They have every right to be as crazy as the men. And if you feel like protesting that newts and toads should have rights too, remember there is no more fulfilling life for an amphibian than to appear every week on Japanese television. We leave you with a reminder of when there was still human life on a garage forecourt, and no woman would even dream of touching anything nasty, let alone stowing it in her boot.
Ending, and we thank you for attending, but before we reach the ending, may we add, remember to be loyal to our gasoline and oil. When they save you time and toil, you'll be glad. We're the Merry Texaco Men. Tonight we may be showmen, tomorrow we'll be servicing your cars.
I wipe the pipe, I pump the gas, I rub the hub, I scrub the glass.
I touch the clutch, I mop the top, I poke the choke, I sell the pop.
I clear the gear, I block the knock, I jack the back, I set the clock.
So join the ranks of those who know, and fill your tank with Texaco. Sky Chief, fill up with Sky Chief, and you will smile at the pile of new miles you will add. Fire Chief, fill up with Fire Chief, you'll find that Texaco's the finest friend your car has ever had. The best friend your car has ever had.
Monday at 9, Eddie Murphy and Dan Aykroyd are trading places.
Help! Help!
I don't want your bag, man!
A topsy-turvy world where street wisdom meets high finance in the chance of a lifetime.
I'll bet that that man could run our company as well as your young Winthorpe.
Dan Aykroyd and Eddie Murphy trade places Monday at 9 on Granada.